Hello my dear friends, this is Rakesh and in today's video we will learn how we can boost our application performance by doing some settings in iOS and in our operating system. So I will discuss all these points in today's videos. So let's discuss the first point, in which we have the optimal good hardware resources and we want to make the good use of that hardware resources. So to get the good output from that particular resources, and we want to increase the our web application performance. So let's move to the IIS. So in IIS we have hosted the multiple applications. Suppose this is your application, and you can go to this application, go and right click and go to the advanced settings. Whenever you go to the advanced setting tab, you will see the application pool, that which application pool is associated with this website. Suppose here is test app. So I will close this app and I will select this application pool. Here I will see the test app. This is the test app. So I will select this and here I will click the advanced settings. In advanced settings, I will scroll down the options. Here you will find one option of maximum worker processes. So whenever you are sending any request to the server, this is the worker process. Only one worker process is allocated to your this website which is serving your request. So you can increase the worker processes. So remember, the worker processes will only improve the performance if you have the good hardware resources, like if you have the good good processor and good amount of random access memory RAM installed on your server. So if you will increase this, you will have the more number of worker processes concurrently will handle the number of requests, and obviously these will put the load on your RAM and the CPU, and you will be able to make the optimal use of your hardware resources, and obviously this will increase the performance of your application. So this was the first thing, in which you are having a good amount of hardware resources and you are making the optimal, how to make the optimal use of your hardware by increasing these worker processes. So you are having the multiple worker processes, and these are parallelly will handle the number of requests and will serve the request more fastly, and your application performance will be boosted, right? And you will do the okay, and two application pool will be allocated to this worker processes and finally to this application. And the second thing is, whenever we are not having much funds and we are having, suppose only 4 GB of RAMRI and having the one processor on that's not having much capacity, and we are doing much huge calculation on the server, and we are storing a large amount of the cache on that server. So in this case, this worker processes which is allocated to this website will request the more memory to the operating system, and as our server is having only 4 GB of memory, and whenever the demand will increase beyond the 4 GB, we are going to get the error, memory out of memory error you will receive. So your application will start throwing the out of memory and internal server 500 errors. So you will start receiving this kind of error. So how we can avoid from such type of the errors, and if we are not having much funds to increase the performance from server, then we also have some alternate. Go to your server and go to computer, right click. And this properties, my computer properties, advanced settings. In advanced setting performance, advanced tag, here change this. Earlier in your option, this option may be automatically managed or it may be custom. Unselect this and put the custom. I have given the 5000 to the 15000. You can also set here as per your demand, your 16000 or whatever. So it's in MB. And remember, whenever you are going to set this space, it will occupy the space from your drive, hard drive, right? So always take care of your space in the hard drive whenever you are going to allocate this minimum space and the maximum allocation in the MBs. So once you will set it and once you will click OK, so whenever the request, whenever the worker process will request and your demand will go beyond the 4 GB, because you are having the 4 GB of the RAM, random access memory, physical memory is only 4 GB, and whenever the demand of according to your load, demand will go beyond the 4 GB, this hardware space will be used for the further calculation. Although this will not be as fast as per your RAM, but it will serve your purpose and you will not get any kind of the out of memory error or internal server error, but your purpose will be solved. But if you really care for the performance and if you want to serve your customers in a better manner, then you have to increase the random access memory, as I have discussed in the first case. But if you are not willing to invest more on that and you want, you're not you're doing heavy calculation and you're storing a large amount of the cache on the server, then obviously the worker process will require the more amount of the memory. And that 4 GB which is allocated, chip memory or RAM or physical memory which is allocated on your server, which is 4 GB, and that will be not enough. So in that case, this hardware space will be used to serve those further calculations, right? So in this case, you can avoid such kind of the errors, and you can boost, run your application in a better way. So in this today's video, I have told you the two approaches. In the first approach, if you have the good hardware, you can increase the worker processes of your application and you can make the optimal use of your hardware. And in the second case, if you are not having the good hardware resources, then you can increase the virtual memory from your operating system. And whenever the demand will increase from the physical memory, suppose that's a 4 GB in your case, then this virtual memory will be used for the further processing and you will not get any kind of the out of memory errors. So I hope this will help you a little bit in your hosting the application. If you find this video any helpful, then please don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you so much for watching this video.